Hello student, today I will cover a very important topic of the database. As I'm giving this knowledge about the class 7th grade, so I have taken such a database which they can understand properly. So what is the first thing you need? You need the data on the Excel sheet. So here is my Excel sheet and I have designed some data here. You can see here. Let me make it somewhat dark so that everyone can able to read it. Here is the data I have just given in front of you. I have written certain name and I have written the type of exam and marks of certain subjects. And I have taken the exam as PT2 and the PT1. So what is the first thing you have to do? You have to arrange the data in the ascending order or the descending order. So we will go to the sort and arrange into the ascending and descending order. Now your data is arranged in the ascending and descending order. Now what is the next thing? You select the whole data. Now go to the data. Here in the outline you can get the subtotal. Now it will ask for certain settings. That setting you have to do. You want change at what field? I want the data according to the name, that is Anju's PT1 and PT's total, Bina's total, then Kishore's totals, Manju's total, Vinita's total I want. And I want total of all the subjects. This is the thing I want. So click OK. Now you observed very closely. Here you can see the total of Anju, Science total, Maths total, SST total. You can see here. Same you can go for Bina also. There you can see the total. D, we have a PT1 record, so single only it has displayed. Then Kishore and then Manju and the Vinita. And then in the end I can get the grand total. So the success of this subtotal can be seen only when you have entered the data properly. So this is the way you can try your subtotal concept. Now other topic I am going to take is analyzing data with the pivot table. So what is the topic I am going to take? Analyzing data with the pivot table. This is the thing you will get it on the page number 23. So what I am doing, I will take this data only. I am not writing some other things. Again, I will go to the subtotal and I remove everything from here. Now this is my plain data. Fine. Now for implementing the pivot table, what is the thing you have to do it? First, you have to select the whole data. Then go to the insert. You can see the pivot table in the tables. Okay, pivot table. Click on the pivot table. Now here it will ask for the existing worksheet or the new worksheet. Let me take the new worksheet only and say okay. Now you can see one new worksheet has been designed and you can see certain things has been happening on this particular worksheet. Now what I am going to do it. Now I will see what is going to happen. Let me move this here. Now we will shift the table. Now first I want to arrange my name in the rows. See, you can see all the name has been displayed in the rows. It is displaying all the names. And later I want the type of exam. That is also I want in the forms of rows. Now you can see it is displayed in the forms of rows. Got it everyone? Now I want the total of all the numbers. I want total of science. I want total of maths. And I want total of SST. This is also I have done. Now you just observe very closely. Anju's record 49. SST 69 and Math 63. Similarly, you get it for the Bina. Similarly, you get it for the DD and then Kishore and then Manju, then Vinita, and overall record you got it. Now you are realizing that what is the difference between subtotal and the pivot table. Right now, I have done the setting which I have implemented in the subtotal. Let me remove all the setting, whatever the setting I have done it. Now I will do something else. Now this time I want to arrange all the names in the column. Now you can see all the names has been arranged in the columns. Now I want type of exam in the rows form. Now you can see here. Now I want total of all the signs here. Now you can see all the total is displaying here individually like this. So entirely is depend upon the person. How it is going to implement, how it is going to see the record of its own database. Is it clear? The difference between adding subtotal in the database and the analyzing data with the pivot table. I hope this concept is clear to all. I will see you in the next video. Keep enjoying and keep learning. Bye to all. Take care, everyone.